We must strengthen labor unions. Here's why, and here's how. We need stronger unions. 50 years ago, workers joined together to get a bigger share of the economy's gains. Unions not only raised wages, but also improved working conditions for everyone. Pressed for legal protections, like the 40-hour work week and worker safety, and thereby strengthened the economy overall. In the big picture, as union membership has weakened, from more than a third of all private sector workers belonging to unions in the 1950s to fewer than 7% today, that decline has mirrored almost exactly the decline of the middle class. Years ago, unions were the great countervailing power to business. Strong unions mean a strong middle class, which means a strong economy. So how do we strengthen unions? First, make it easier to form a union, with a simple majority of workers voting up or down. Right now, long delays and procedural hurdles give big employers plenty of time to whip up campaigns against unions. Second, build in real penalties on companies that violate labor laws by firing workers who try to organize a union. Nowadays, the worst that can happen is employers have to repay lost wages to the workers they fire. Finally, and this has been in the news a lot lately, if you remember only one thing, remember this. We must enact a federal law that overturns so-called state right-to-work laws. And don't be fooled by the name. It's a backdoor to destroying unions. If no one pays dues, unions have no resources to organize. And that means lower wages and the loss of other worker protections. In fact, wages in right-to-work states are lower than wages in non-right-to-work states by an average of about $6,000 a year. Workers in right-to-work states are also less likely to have employer-sponsored health insurance and pension coverage. And the lowering tide pulls down all the boats. All workers in states with right-to-work laws, those in unions or not, are worse off. American workers need a union to bargain on their behalf, including low-wage workers in big-box retail stores and fast food chains. If we want working Americans to get a fair share of the gains from economic growth, they must be able to unionize.